Hey everybody, Shawn Clement here from the Richmond Hill Golf Learning Center. And today's topic is kinetic sequence. So I had one of my students film me just throwing a ball into one of my nets just out front of the our hitting area here on the range. Now I'm going to start this off. So you notice how I'm just getting ready to throw right now. And you'll notice as I start moving toward the net with my lower body, that's when my arm actually starts to rise. So notice how my left foot still hasn't reached the ground. Now, boom, now the left foot connects with the ground and the kinetic chain starts. It goes up my leg, now my quad starts to fire, and then from the quad it goes through my hip. Notice how my hips are starting to move. So my left leg is now using the ground to clear my upper body. So now it goes through my torso, through my shoulder, and right about there, you'll see how the muscles in my neck, I don't know if you can get this to focus here, you'll see the muscles in my neck are firing right now because the muscles in that part of the back have to support the weight of the arm and the shoulder and everything else firing through. So that kinetic sequence has gone all the way through from the ground, through the leg, through the hips, through the torso, up into my right elbow, and then finally, right there, it's fully loaded and delivering. And then from there it continues, there's that release. So now my body becomes relaxed at that point. The ball is gone. Okay? So how does this apply to the golf swing? And you guys remember, I want you to go to my throwing the club video. So if I'm throwing the club to my target, I gather my backswing. And you notice how my whole backside is facing the target. If you watch a baseball pitcher in the full-blown range of motion, the back is facing the target. That knee is back here, but you notice how the body is ready to go this way. So the body is carrying this way to go get the ground. Now that I have the ground, and you notice how that foot opens up, now the whole body starts to retract. And that's what pulls. So the left side going back is what pulls that right side forward, and that's what pulls that elbow into position. So as I gather back, I have to have the time to go get the ground with that left leg. Now the left leg can use the ground to get my body out of the way so that I can throw at my target. So you notice there's a very specific sequence that occurs in the swing, and in order for you to get the conditions for that, we need a full cycle of momentum. What do we need? What do we mean by full cycle of momentum? Well, I got my trusty ball on a string. So, number one, go see throwing the club, Shawn Clement. Number two, ball on a string, Shawn Clement. So if I want the ball to go toward my target, I have my keep out sign. You guys keep hearing that. One day you're going to see it. So, and all of you who've been here, you know, and get up close and go, oh, there's that keep out sign you keep talking about. So one cycle, two cycles, three cycles toward that keep out sign. Now, because my intent is on releasing this ball at the keep out sign, I have to wait for the next cycle. There's no choice in the matter, right? I can't force gravity. I have to respect gravity. So, one, two, three. Right on the keep out sign. Perfect. So, there it is. So my body is able to time itself with that cycle, okay? So if I go to a longer club, that ball and a string was like an 8-iron. If I had a driver in my hands, it'd be a lot more out and away from me. Well, then it'd be a longer lasting cycle, wouldn't it? So it's one, two, three to the keep out. One, two, three. And rope went straight into that keep out sign. So there's a really cool little tool here that I want to show you. It's called a hitting stick. So you notice that this baseball size ball at the end here, nice and long, and you just basically hold it out there for somebody to use a baseball bat. And we've discovered that this works extremely well, like those orange whip tools, and it is extremely long. So you notice the length of this is a lot longer. We're looking at, you know, about 60 inches. And every one of my students who swung this realized that they had to wait for the next cycle of momentum. And when you swing this compared to a driver, when you take your driver, it'll feel like a wedge in your hands, okay? So it's got a lot of benefits. So you feel the weight of the ball. So I'm going to take this ball and I'm going to throw it toward the keep out sign. So here we go. Throw it out there. So you notice how I had to wait for that cycle to complete itself. Now a golf club is shorter and lighter and much easier to manipulate. So you could yank it back, push it through, but that wouldn't do you any good, would it? Because as you yank it back, push it through, now the body can't go get the ground. And the body, like in a punch, if you take a punch and you go sideways here, snap a punch in this direction, right away you'll feel you have to shift your weight. And that's not something you need to think about. You're already wired for this stuff. So you shift the weight, you clear the body, you haven't even thrown the punch yet. And you'll notice that your body has to do this out of pure self-preservation. This is the kinetic sequence, okay? So in order for me to have a proper kinetic sequence with the swing, my eyes are on the ball, but my attention is on the keep-out sign and on the feel of me throwing the club toward the keep-out sign. So, feel the weight of my arm club unit. Use that weight to throw the club into that keep-out sign. So you'll notice there's a nice pause at the top of my swing. Well, that's an absolute necessity because this is me allowing the club to change directions on its own. This is me not interfering with the change in direction. So, that's the golf club changing directions on its own. Takes a while, doesn't it? So, here's one cycle. Two cycles. Three cycles. Now, if we put this in our perpetual motion drill, you can actually feel a kinetic sequence in your perpetual motion drill when you're allowing the arm club unit to swing freely. So I'm going to do a 1-2-3 throw to the keep out sign. One keep out. Two to keep out. Three to keep out. Whew, beautiful throw. So you notice if we put that in slow motion, I'm going to put this in slow motion for you right now. So you noticed in the slow motion swing, as I'm coming to the top, as my arm's going back, I'm actually moving forward with the lower body. So as the arms are getting to the top, they're becoming weightless. As gravity is hovering and making this arm club unit weightless, now my body has the time to go get the ground and prepare for what's to come. Now it can get the body out of the way as the arms are falling. And as the body gets out of the way, chick, 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 all that kinetic chain goes all the way through to the club head, and then everything is released out there toward the target. So what you need to do is practice full cycles of momentum. Massive backswing, massive follow through, and hit the ball, let's say with a 7-iron, hit it 100 yards. Throw it gently, okay? So let me see if I go to my 7-iron right here again. That other club here was a 3-iron, so I can throw the club gently. So here's a gentle throw to the keep out sign. Feel the weight of the arm club unit. There's a nice gentle throw. That probably would have been about 125, 130 yards. Now, if I want to go farther, what do? All I need to do is throw it farther. Now, imagine if you were throwing the ball farther in a ball throw. So here's a gentle throw, same kinetic sequence, and here's a throw that goes farther. So I have to wait, use the ground, get my body out of the way to catapult the arm toward the target. Same thing here. So all I want to do is throw the 7-iron farther out toward my target. Very low strain, but a higher velocity in my throw. So notice my lower body starts to become a little more active because it has to get out of the way sooner so that because the arms are going to catch up to it. So gentle throw. And you'll notice that everything's coordinating very, it looks like it's moving together. And you'll notice now if I throw it farther, the lower body is going to activate sooner. That was me throwing it as far as I could without the strain. So you see that explosion of energy was there, not there. So when we're looking for that kinetic sequence, we don't want the kinetic sequence in relation to the ground, we want it in relation to the target. Which leads me to, hey, you know, Sean, sometimes I feel like I'm coming out of the shot. Well, I asked them, I said, are you trying to hit the ball? I said, what do you mean? Well, what's in your mind when you look down at the ball? The ball? Well, if the ball is your target, then you're going to go throw the club at the ball. Well, that's very different. So that my kinetic sequence, now you notice if I'm tossing any kind of heavy object, I'm going to be using my legs. See how my legs are pushing off the ground? One to the keep outside. Two to the keep outside. Three to the keep outside. So if I'm doing the same in a throw, one to the keep out, two, three at the ball. So if I throw at the ball, I'm going to have to jump up to throw things down here. But if I'm throwing things out there, that lifting, that extension with the legs is going to happen later, and I'm going to have a tendency to stay down through the shot. So a nice throw out there, low strain. You see how I'm staying nicely with the shot when that happens? But if I was throwing at the ball, it'd be a completely different story. I'd have a tendency to come up and out of my shot too soon. And that'll happen too when, you know, you're straining too hard and too soon in the swing. Could you imagine if I tried to swing this thing as hard and as fast as possible? The thing would definitely come back and hit me in the head. So that's, I can feel that. That's why these, you know, this tool actually has a really good use to it in order for you to wait for that full cycle of momentum so you can throw it out there. So I hope you enjoyed that. And we'll see you in the next video.